Hey, Fredo, have y'all tuned in to GV Hot 97? I got it.
My weapon of choice.
Y'all better ask somebody.
Stay tuned. Stay connected. GV Hot 97.
Let's go. I just wanna give them all the praise. I just wanna give them all the bad.
Tune in, practitioner's phone, and he's at it again.
What you got? Let's go. Come for fastball with GV Hot 97.
Sit back,
tune in,
practitioner's phone, and he's at it again.
What you got? Let's go. Come for fastball with GV Hot 97.
Straight back it up with scripture. Greg Moe, no practitioner, the bishop. GV Hot 97 on a mission. But this is our guy, we just blessed with the vision. Prayed for a soul, he gave us a vision. And now we go live, cooking meals in the kitchen. Glory to God, stay tuned and listen to the grown folks' gospel with the bishop.
The Bishop on GV Hot 97, and my co-host is Miss Lioness. What's going on, girl?
What's up, Bishop. We back again.
Glory to God. Yes, yes, we are. Again. We have a very special guest today, Jonas Run. What's up, y'all?
What's going on? God bless you.
Man, glory to God. Glad to have y'all here today.
Glad to be had here today. Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
We in the building. We are in the building. Do you all see who we have today? We got Jonas Run. Let me say that for you again. J-O-N-A-H-S. Jonas Run. Oh boy, Bishop, I'm excited today.
I am so excited, man. You guys sound so great. It's just so different, so unique. And you know, in the gospel field, you want to hear something that's not the same, not, you know, and you guys are very unique. I love your song. Tell us about the song here.
Sweet Life. Sweet Life is the last single that we put out. Well, not the last single. We have a current single out, but we put it out this past summer. And it just is reflective of the mood that we were in at the time. Even as Corona was raging, you know, God was still blessing. And we just felt like in spite of what's going on, you know, you've got to speak the life that you want, you know. So yeah. We felt like in the middle of an epidemic, it was time to say that the people of God can still live a sweet life.
Beautiful, beautiful. So look, tell us how you all got together, where you all from.
Absolutely. We are from Hampton, Virginia. Takai's from Rhode Island, but she spent most of her time here. Shout out to my little sister. She'll be with us tomorrow. Absolutely. But we were an R&B group, Sherrod and myself, back in the 90s. And Takai had a girl group, and we had the same manager. So that's how we all originally met. Further down the line, different ones started receiving their callings in Christ because most of us were from church. One of our former members became an apostle, and for his 45th birthday, we thought it would be fun for us to get together at his birthday party to sing some of the old songs. The party ended up being canceled, but we were together. We had the time. The Spirit of God was there, so we kept it going.
Wow. That is so beautiful. So you all got together in Hampton, Virginia, and tell us about the chemistry. How did you guys fit the chemistry into what you were trying to do?
That's a great question, because originally it was four guys, and that was really kind of the way Sherrod and I really liked it and envisioned it. When we got back together, the original group was called Elite, and it was four guys. One of them decided that he wanted to do a solo, and the other one got married and didn't have the time or what have you. So the Lord impressed on me to ask Takai to sing with us, which all those years she had never done. And I fought it and fought it because I had envisioned, you know, a four guy group. You know, I've never really been into choirs or ensembles other than listening. But Sherrod and I, we were like Otis and Blue in The Temptations when it was just the two of them. You know, they were in the bathroom with the card trying to figure out what to do. So, you know, I said, you know, Lord, I hear you. I'm going to stop fighting it. So I asked her, and I kind of asked her hoping she would say no, so at least I obeyed God. But she jumped right on it and right in it, went shopping, FaceTiming me with outfits. And we've just picked up momentum every day since then.
So how did the dynamic change once you added a woman? I'm just asking because, you know, I am a woman and I do rep for the ladies out there. How did the dynamics change? Because the first thing you said is she started sending you outfits. Like, y'all don't, guys don't be thinking about that, you know? Like, we gonna match? Are y'all wearing the same color I'm wearing?
Absolutely. Right. All of that kind of thing. And I had to start allotting for time because I'm a real stickler about time. And it doesn't take me and Sherrod nearly as much time to get dressed, you know? Like, we show up for a photo shoot. Sherrod and I put our clothes on when we come and leave the house in what we're wearing for the photo shoot. We get there, we
You ain't supposed to be telling our secrets now. You ain't supposed to be telling us. Where my girl at?
I had to stick an extra 30 minutes on everything to allow her makeup time. That took some getting used to.
Wow.
Bishop, don't agree. Please, Bishop, don't join in on this conversation.
I'm neutral, okay. You know. But, thank you. I do say y'all.
But she brought a an emotional dynamic to us that we did not have, and a range. She gave us you know, because she's a naturally a high alto, it gave us a range to do other things musically that four guys couldn't have done.
Right.
So, and she makes us look good. You guys haven't seen her yet, but she's a beautiful young lady.
Yeah,
she I see her in the pictures now.
You know, she makes us look good.
She makes us look good.
Well, I ain't going to say nothing about that. You know what I'm saying? You know, I ain't going to be the one to say nothing on that.
Hey, it is what it is.
You know, when I looked at the album cover with the three of y'all with that sky in the background, mm-hmm. and it's so iconic. And it actually reminds me of back in the day, you got me hanging on the string now.
I know what you're talking. I know who you're talking about.
You
I
know who I'm talking about?
Yeah, yes.
That's before my time.
Oh, you know what?
No, I'm not.
I'm getting off of here. No. It's all you. Wow. It's all you. I'm going to wait till my girl
joke
comes.
Joke.
I tell you. So,
Bishop, you're wrong for chuckling at that. You're dead wrong.
I'm sorry. I mean, but wow. So, you all sound like you all have been in like groups, like you all were lead singers, and you all just came together to form a group, and it's such a beautiful thing. You know what I mean? Do you all write and produce all of your stuff, or you have someone to come in and do that?
We do.
How hard has it been for y'all to move in this current climate? You talking about COVID-19. Tell me how y'all have been able to move around, like, you know.
Well, as far as live performances, we've done two virtual concerts. Mm-hmm. But what we've really focused on mostly during this time is writing more songs. Right. We're working on an EP right now, so we have the time to do it and just being in studio. And prayerfully, you know, things will be lifted or changed this summer, and we plan on making a big impact through and by the grace of God.
Can I ask another question? I said I wasn't going to speak, but I am. I'm going to speak. Who does what? Rod, Mike, I seen you guys when Sweet Life was on, and I mean, we could tell that's your own music because there's an intimacy to it, you know, a connection to it. But who does what? Rod, what role do you play? Mike, what role do you play? And role does Takai play in this? I mean, creatively.
She asked you first.
Okay, well, Mike is the, he's the songwriter. Mike is the songwriter. And he writes all the material. And I told Mike, I said, I would put him up there with the best of them when it comes to the songwriting, like the baby faces and the...
Oh, wow.
Baby
faces are a huge writer, hit writer.
Remind me to cash up you that $20 for pumping me up like that.
That's all he get is 20, though. Like, we can't get no big face hundreds. We can't get no 20.
Well, as far as our roles, I do write all of the material. Sherrod and Takai I'm a musician, and they are my instruments. They are the primary lead singers. Sweet Life was all Sherrod and Takai. The next song you play is mostly Takai. They are my instruments. They're my muse. They breathe life into whatever I write. And in the studio, I kind of let them interpret what I write, you know, themselves and put themselves in it. And we just kind of see what happens. And usually it's great.
So look, we're ready to go to a break and hear on from here. But when we come back, we're going to talk about social injustice. Okay.
Okay.
Already got it.
Ooh, oh, oh. Let's go.
There have been days when it seemed like my world was full of rain. Yes, there were times.
wanna talk to everybody suffering over a broken relationship. Everybody in bondage waiting on closure that may never come. I wanna talk to every divorcee, every person whose friends or family have turned their back on them, every pastor who has suffered loss in your ministry. Don't you lose another night's sleep? Don't you shed another tear? Through and by the grace of God, say this with us.
Now life's not through. I'm learning to get over you, finding the strength to move on. I take it day by day. His grace, it takes the pain away. Finally, the strength to move on.
And oh, I've had to shed some tears, but now I shed my fears. I'm moving on from here. Oh, I've had to shed some tears, but now I shed my fears. I'm moving on from here. Oh,
shedding my tears.
I've had to shed some tears.
No more fears.
But now I shed my fears.
No more fears.
Jonas Run, glory to God, the Bishop on GB Hot 97 with the Lioness.
Jonas Run, oh my goodness, that glory is such a smooth groove.
Yes, it is. What inspired you all to write this song?
Well, the hook to it, I found out life's not through, learning to get over you. That's a hook I actually had in the 90s for an R&B song that I never finished. And when this music was given to me, it kind of reminded me of a Frankie Beverly type of thing. And funny thing about it, when I wrote the song, I had no idea how the emotions it would bring out of Takai. We were in the studio, she was in the booth, and she was just crying. And, you know, so we were waiting for her to get herself together. And she said, I didn't tell you this, but it's like you wrote my life, this song, because she had some relationships and some things that she had been struggling to move on from. And funny story, producer, as he was mixing and mastering, and shout out to Darius Mines, my cousin who produced this track for us. He said, man, you got me in here crying and bobbing my head at the same time. My emotions are all in an uproar. He said, this song is, he said, I don't know whether to cry or keep bobbing my head, but he said, you got me messed up. I think at the time he might've been like 25. So I said, wow, to reach and touch someone at that age level tells me that we're reaching all age groups.
Wow, that's a beautiful thing.
I was just gonna say, I think that I can see that, cause you know, I'm a girl, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But I can see the emotional thread there. And not only that, the message that you're giving, it's all throughout, but especially the detailed encouragement, the motivation, you know, that you're giving at the end, it's needed, you know, but it also makes you think about others. Well, what are they going through? What are the pastors? Right. Because sometimes we don't step outside of ourselves and really think about others. So,
everybody has had or will have to move on from something in their life. If you haven't yet, keep living and you will.
You're right. And God elevates you to different levels. And when
absolutely,
you know, and everyone can't go with you. So, you know, you appreciate the experiences that you had and you thank God because he built you up to be who you are today.
That's right. And when people leave you or there's different levels of severing in your life, You may go through your period of grieving. That's fine.
Right.
Now, you've been married 20 years and your wife, your husband walks out on you. No matter how deep in Christ you are, that's going to hurt. But understand that life's not over. I'm going to cry, but I'm going to come out of this. I'm going to put my makeup back on. I'm going to go back out on the town. I'm going to clean myself up, shave. Eventually, I'm going to get over you and I'm going to move on because God has graced me. Life doesn't stop here.
Right.
Absolutely. Life doesn't stop here. God, and I'm going to trust God every step of the way. So when it comes to social injustice and what's going on around our country, how have you used your platform to identify that and to help those situations on your platform?
Well, I'll start this off, then I'll give it to Sherrod because he's really the social justice warrior of the group. and really, Sherrod was way more active than us. You know, he would be at all of the rallies and petitioning for police reform and what have you. Of course, the George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, those things happening back to back, you know, it affected the whole world, you know, nationally and internationally. And I was driving one day and I was listening to some accounts of the George Floyd incident before I had seen the video. But then once I saw the video, I called Sherrod and I was in tears and we were working on a worship album. And I said, man, we got to switch gears. I mean, the Spirit of God fell on me real heavy. And I said, we got to start speaking out in this next EP. You know, it might not even end up being, quote, a gospel EP, but we're Black men, we're Black women, and we're also artists. So as artists, I said, even if we have to step out of the pulpit, we need to speak to what's going on socially in the world. So that's what we're doing with this project that we're working on now. And I'll let Sherrod take it from there.
Just piggyback off of what Mike said, the George Floyd incident, it woke a sleeping giant, basically. It awakened a sleeping giant of the world. I think that's when, whether you are Black, brown, even some white people had enough, calling on police reform. As officers, they need to be held accountable to the same standards that we are. They need to be hooked and booked, just like we are, fired, and not be able to go to another state and just pick up where you left off. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. And so the EP that we're working on now is entitled War 846, and it's in honor of George Floyd. And when we say war, that scares some non-Black people. But you'll see during the course of the EP that the war that we're fighting is a spiritual war. The Bible says we wrestle not against flesh and blood. You know, so War 846 is going to be the title track, but the song that we've released now is called Until You Treat Me Right. It simply says that we as a people collectively can't breathe.
Right.
Collectively, as a people, we're all waiting to exhale, waiting until we're treated fairly.
Right.
In society, in all facets. Next on the agenda, short term, we're going, the video that you're going to play later, is this the video to the song, but it also highlights a very important part of Black history that happened here in Virginia at Fort Monroe, the contraband slave decision. I don't know if you've heard of that. What happened was Fort Monroe was taken over by the Union, so it became Northern Territory, and three slaves in the middle of the night left their master and went and banged on the gate to be let in, and they made a decision that, okay, we've taken over this territory, so these slaves are now considered contraband. So we still weren't considered human, but we were considered spoils of war. But in them allowing them to come in, it started an exodus, which really crippled the Confederacy. And so the video celebrates the sacrifice and the boldness of those three slaves. And there's a whole society called the Contraband Society. Thousands of people who are living descendants all over the country. And they have been pushing the song. I've had presidents from colleges who are descendants who said, I'm showing this to my class. You know, so we're really going to be pushing it hard.
Absolutely. I think we all need to have an open dialogue.
Absolutely.
You know, and let's talk about it and not be scared of the topic.
Well, how can we move forward if we're not having the conversation?
Right.
I feel like I want to take my glasses off on this one, y'all.
Watch yourself.
Hey, look at him now. I done seen the video. Watch out. But the problem that we have, period, is that we're so busy hiding secrets. So we're so busy burying the things that we feel like embarrass us about our family, but it's the reason why we can't move on. Right. Because we're not uprooting those things that have caused division, that have caused hatred, mm-hmm. that has caused violence. We just keep on burying it, and people are not healing from it. And so it's just becoming a poison from generation to generation. So we do got to talk about it.
And unfortunately, Lioness, the only people they don't want to hear from seems to be us. I've had that said to me. And I remind them that the children of Israel, when they were in Egypt, they had their rights taken from them. Right. And Moses defended one of his brothers who was being beaten by an Egyptian guard. That's police brutality. That sparked mm-hmm. the exodus of Israel.
And what did Moses say? Let my people go.
That's right.
Let my people go. Is that not slavery?
Yeah, that wasn't spiritual bondage. They were literally physically in bondage. Let's not be extra deep. Let's not be deep. It wasn't a soul tie. They were literally in bondage.
Right, bondage.
Right, right.
They didn't need to go to a conference about soul ties. They was in bondage.
It was a pleasure having you all on the Grateful Gospel Radio Show.
The pleasure has been all ours.
Thank you so much for having us. We are on all digital platforms at Jonas Run One. That's the number one.
I got one more question for Jonas Run.
Absolutely.
When you are in the Midwest, come on, somebody, who you rocking with?
Next time Jonas Run is in the Midwest, you can find us at Hot 97.
Well, yeah. I felt that in my shine.
I was about to lay prostrate.
Y'all ready? And we are closing out with "Until You Treat Me Right" by Jonas Run.
All right.
Would you look at that? Old Glory, beautiful. Doesn't get any more American than that, Rocky Balboa and the 4th of July fireworks. Ah, the smell of apple pie. Now that's American. America's game, the Bambino, baby. Land of the free, home of the brave. Hey, I was at that match. You tell them, Ricky Bobby. You want to know what else is American?
Go down to Moses, my love. You go way down in a Egypt land till you meet no Pharaoh. Let my people go.
Somebody asked the question, can we all just get along? I don't know if we'll find the answer by the end of this song. Somebody had this idea that all we need is love. But when a king is killed for dreaming, maybe it's just not enough. But I know I can't breathe until you treat me right. And I know I can't breathe until you look me in the eye. And I'll keep my hands up until you face the truth. And I'll keep my hands up that I'm a part of you.
Refuse of the
teenage show. Somebody built a statue for those yearning to breathe free. while I'm suffocated by statues not intended for me. Somebody asked the question, can we all just get along?
And I hope I'll find the answer
by the end of this song. But I know.
Treat me right,
and I know, I can't
breathe, until you look me in the eye,
I'm gonna keep my hands up.